All right, everyone, in this final section of our DataViz Whys and Wins quick bite presentation, I'm gonna talk about making unique charts in everyday software like PowerPoint and Excel. So we know that we have access to lots of standard charts in PowerPoint, just like this. This is our chart picker. But what we're going to do, we don't have access to some of those really cool charts that we talked about earlier, some of those interesting, more unique charts, but we're gonna make those charts from the standard or the stock charts that we have in PowerPoint. We just have to use some of their features to sort of co-opt the software into creating these charts for us. And I'm gonna show you just a few of the little examples of this kind of co-opting behind the scenes here. So here we're going to make that framed bar chart. The framed bar chart is going to show us, in this case, we're going to visualize themes. Maybe it's themes from conservation action interviews that we did here at the zoo. Now we're going to make this framed bar chart from a clustered bar chart or a paired bar chart that is the default chart in PowerPoint or Excel as well, if you're working in that software. Now, this is how the data would be set up in your Excel sheet. Now, you normally would have, you know, whatever your themes are right here and the data in column blue, but in this case, we need to add a helper column. And I love Anne Emery. She calls these helper columns. I really love that terminology. This is helper. We're adding this helper column and we're putting it exactly in this order. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to head over to our software. We're going to select all of these data and we're going to insert this clustered bar chart. And now what we're going to do with that clustered bar chart. This is what it looks like here. That gray bar is the 100%. We're gonna click those bars. We're gonna go to the series option tab right here on our format data series menu, and under series overlap, we're gonna just slide it from 0 to 100%, and that overlaps the bars. And from there, it's just formatting. You're gonna add some labels, but that's a really cool way to make these framed bar charts. Super cool. Another thing that you might want to make are these fun icon arrays. So this is probably, you know, something that we've all made. Maybe it's like visualizing a scale or an overall experience rating, a 5-star rating. And you can see that we're going to actually make this in the exact same way. We're going to make it from a paired bar chart just like this. But this is how your data are going to have to be set up. You're going to have that helper column, and that's going to be whatever your maximum rating is. So in our case, the maximum rating is 5. And then you also need to have two icons or two pictures that you're able to color. So they're going to be duplicates. They're going to be duplicate pictures, but one of them is going to be gray. That's going to be for your gray, the gray bar kind of in the background. And then one of them is going to be your data color, whatever color you're going to use. So these are two icons that I got right from PowerPoint. And so here is how I thought about doing that. What you're going to do is you're going to control C to copy one of the pictures. So in this case, I'm gonna go ahead and control C to copy the gray star right here. I'm gonna control C, now I'm gonna push the gray bar, I'm gonna select the gray bar, and I'm gonna control V to paste the star into the bar. Now you can see it looks really stretched, but I'm gonna go to the format data point menu, that paint bucket right there. If you go all the way down to this little button that says stack and scale with, that's going to create lots of versions of that icon, and you get 5 versions of the icon. Perfect, it matches the data. You're gonna do the same thing for the blue bar, copy, control C and control V to paste that in, go up to that paint bucket, hit stack and scale with, and now you have a really cool version of that chart. Now you're gonna have to overlap those bars just like we did before. So go to the data, the series options menu right there, and then drag the series overlap from 0 to 100%, and now you have your icon array. From here, it's a little bit of formatting. You have to go ahead and adjust the dimensions, the height, to make sure that the icons aren't really squished or stretched, but it looks really cool. Kind of a nice technique. Now, another chart that I love to make is a dot plot. This is not a default chart type or a native chart type in PowerPoint and Excel, but it's really nice, remember, for showing mean scores or average ratings, those summary statistics. And I think I'm not going to really show you how to make this because we have videos about how to make it, and it does involve a little bit more elbow grease behind the scenes to make these perfect. But essentially, these are just scatter plots. So we do have an XY scatter plot by default in PowerPoint and Excel. So scatter plots plot a single data, they plot the data point based on two values. So you have an X value and you have a Y value, and that's where it's plotted. But what we're gonna do is we're gonna take the intention of this chart and make a dot plot with it by making the Y values just the numbers along those lines. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, that's gonna be my Y values. And then the X values are gonna be my horizontal values. So if I do that, that's how it will look. The dot plot shows those values along a single line. So this is how your data would look right here. And then over here, this is how you would put it in the XY scatter plot. The X value would be your data value, the data that the value that you want to show. And then the Y value would simply be that helper column of continuous data, 4, 3, 2, 1, however many plots you have. And then this is kind of what that's going to look like when you put it in by default in Excel or PowerPoint. So there's going to be a lot more zhuzhing up that you have to do in terms of formatting to this, but that's going to be the bones of the scatter plot. And I will link below to a video on how to make dot plots in PowerPoint. And all it will include all of those different steps for zhuzhing it up. And then finally, I want to show an example of that diverging stacked bar chart because it's really nice. So we're going to go back to our bird-friendly behavior option. And this diverging stacked bar chart just comes from a stacked bar chart, a default or a native stacked bar chart here in PowerPoint. So this is how you're going to have to set up your data. The blue columns, that's my data, difficult, neither, easy. Those are the three columns of data that I have. I've set that I want my diverging point or my cut point to be between neither and easy. You could set this to be wherever you want it to. It could be between neither and difficult or however you think it looks best. But what we're going to have to do now is we're going to have to create some helper columns on either side. You see helper column 1 and 2, and each of those cells is going to have a formula that references the column next to it. So for all the things that I want on my left side of my diverging point, the difficult and neither, the formula in that helper cell is going to be 100% minus the sum of whatever difficult and neither are. So we just do equals parentheses 1 minus the sum of difficult and neither of whatever is in are in those two columns. So that's just basically taking that and it's giving me the difference between what that would be and 100%. So everything to the left of the diverging point has to sum to 100%, and everything to the right of the diverging point has to sum to 100%. That's probably an easier way to say it. I should have started off with that to begin with. So my helper column 2, the formula is, since I only have one column to the right of my diverging point, my helper column 2 is just going to say 100% minus whatever is in that cell right there. So once you get that, take a screenshot of this and look at it. Don't take my word for it. Just sit with it for a little while and try it with your own data. You're going to select the entire table of data, and we're going to insert a stacked bar chart, a 100% stacked bar chart. And it's not going to look like this. I did a little bit of formatting, but it's going to look something similar to this. You're going to be able to see that you have these two helper columns on the side of data. And so all you need to do with those helper columns is make them white or turn them to no fill. So just select that helper column series, go to the paint bucket, and select no fill. And you're going to do that to the other one. And now you can really quickly see there is my diverging stacked bar chart. Now in the 100%, we don't need the axis here. Now we can get rid of those helpers, just isolate them by double clicking those values and then getting rid of those. We can move our legend over. Now on our axis, we're going to update the minimum and maybe the maximum right there around 20%. Let's update the minimum to about 20% so that we can fill more of the plot area with the data. And that's going to stretch the chart a little bit more. That looks really nice. Now we can probably get rid of that axis. And if you really wanted to get rid of the y-axis line over here, we don't really need that. So you just select that, go over to the paint bucket, and say no line. And now you have a really beautiful diverging stacked bar chart. And from here, it's formatting. You want to add some labels and do a little bit more zhuzhing around as you see fit. But it's pretty cool. So I hope this gives you a little bit of an idea of the things that you can do inside of Excel working with the built-in chart defaults or the built-in chart elements to create unique non-native charts in PowerPoint that really share your data in really, really effective ways. So I hope you like this series of quick bites. I had a great time recording them for you. If you do, please give everything a like and a thumbs up, hit the subscribe button, all that good stuff. And I will post all the relevant links here below in the comments below. But otherwise, I had a great time making this for you. I can't wait to see you next time, and I hope to see you around.